Hello, it's Swan here, and welcome back to another video, and today we've got a bit of a quicker video, because essentially, what Urban Rivals announced today is, in daily tournament, they're going to be having yet another bot where you have a whole chance of obtaining a whole bunch of very useful and viable cards, including the new Frozen, which I'm not going to try and even pronounce. Of course, last week, they also had yet another bot, which, to be honest, I don't even know why that bot was in-game. It just kind of appeared, and I don't think there was really ever any formal announcements. What is my cat doing? Please, don't be on a destructive path. But what I thought would be fun to do is go back and basically go through the games which I managed to do against the bots. So, for our first game, to be honest, the deck which the bot were playing were actually fairly decent. I weren't really too worried, because I know the one which we had around Christmas time or New Year's was absolutely horrible, but a lot of it were just sort of damage reduction and whatnot. I sort of debated what to play, and I figured Malphas was probably my best shout. That's the card which would be the least affected by its power manip, and also with the map BMAP's massive damage, I kind of gaffered. If I win this round, that's going to put me at a really good leverage. Next up, he plays Traffers, and again, I knew that the bot was barely going to play any pills at all. And I think at this point, I was trying to do some massive mental gymnastics and figure out just how much damage the bot could do. I think in total, the maximum damage the bot could do would be 16, but then with Effigy's ability, that dropping down to 13. So that would then reduce me down to 7 damage. If I went for Feles, of course, that would bring me down to 12 minus 8 damage, which would then be 4, plus 2 pills would be 6. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah. Even now, when I'm trying to go back through it and figure out just how much damage the bot could do, I just kind of gaffered, you know what? I'm going to have enough of a life gap to win. So I think eventually, after a while, sure enough, I did go for Feles, and I furied him, and yeah, then I bring him down to 5 life. So all I had to do now was just wait for him to play. I think at first I went for Effigy, because yeah, I thought he'd go for Harold, which he sure enough did, very fortunately. And did even fury, because the bot probably wouldn't be programmed to do so, and even then ended up winning the round against Effigy, so I knew that were a sure enough win. So that was game one done and dusted. Very nice. So to go through the prices, I remember the top row wasn't really anything amazing. Again, a lot of common cards which weren't all that great. But I got a Prisma Jacob and Prisma Doggernut, Prisma Dan, Prisma Essie, Starf LD, which I was very happy about. But again, rest of it wasn't really anything to write home about. Definitely prizes weren't quite as massive as the 18-year celebration. For game two, I think I had the first round. My hand was looking, again, still decent, and cards which he had weren't really too scary. Again, other than probably that Bamappe and maybe Slabble. But what I thought I'd do is go for Ikare, and I think I played about, was it 5 pills, I want to say? Oh no, I went for Evil Robin. But yeah, I went for 5 pills. And bot ends up going for Bamappe again. Played very low pills, which is not what I expected. But we won that round, which was absolutely spot on. And yeah, at this point, because my internet had been playing up massively, I started to proper panic, and I thought, oh no, we've had timeouts whilst I'm against the bot, I'll just be absolutely heartbroken. So I was just very frantically waiting for my game to reconnect. I was sort of debating, do I need to swap over to my phone so that I can actually finish this battle? Because last thing I want to do is miss out. Bot goes for Harrow LD, so I know at that point, yeah, go for Feles. Go all in, because that's going to be sure enough a KO. And what do you know, it is. So, yeah, again, absolutely thrilled by that result. A nice and easy win. And then this time, clearly got to level 231, that's nice. But prices, again, a lot of common cards, which I weren't really too concerned about. But what I was really happy about was that Prisma Lucian, because I know him alone, he's worth like a solid 400k. Got a love another load of Prismas, Baffa LD, Betel. Yeah, but overall, not a too bad result for that game. And then for our final matchup, this time he doesn't have his Bamape LD, but he does have Heather and also that Roderick, which both cards I was quite scared of, not gonna lie. So I think for my first round, I wasn't quite sure what to play, but went Ikare because I figured that'd be the least SOA prone card. But he ends up going for that Sunita, which is really bad. I played probably a bit too many pills considering what the bot had been doing up to then in the game. But then he goes for Lafleur, so I think at this point I was thinking, yeah, go for Malphas again. It's probably again doing some maths in my head to figure out what's the maximum damage you'd be able to do, which with both Roderick and Heather, that'd be a maximum of about 15 damage, which meant for sure that I needed to win with my Malphas. But what I end up actually doing is playing Winchester, which I don't really know why I'd do that. Maybe I was just expecting him not to play that much on that card, and luckily it doesn't. But I think then I was sort of slightly panicking. I'm thinking, if I don't win this third round, then I'm kind of done for. Definitely didn't know how this game would pan out. Kind of thinking, well, what's he going to do? Will he go all in Roderick, or would he maybe old Heather? Would he old Roderick or go all in Heather? I weren't really sure, but I think by this point, what I gathered I needed to do was just go for it, go all in, and hope that the bot didn't match me. So I end up going for Kolos. And, okay, yeah, so I played 32 attack because I figured, did I play 32 on Kolos? Oh no, I just old Kolos. But yeah, I got kind of gaffered that he'd go for the Roderick. And, very luckily, I didn't play that much on my Kolos, because otherwise, 100% would have lost that round and lost against the bots. But luckily, made the right call, so then I could just go for my Heather. Go for Malphas. And Furious and secure a KO for my third and final win against the bot. And then this time for my rewards, again, still quite a lot of common cards. Nothing too astounding, really. Did get some more Prismas, so Cosmo Kirkan. Got a Jan Ghost, which I wasn't too thrilled about because I already owned that LD. Got an Lucian LD as well, so that weren't too bad. And then in terms of the rares, got Carl, which is a card which I do really like from Bangers, as well as Joy and Wooly. But yeah, that was the final results from those games. So like I said, those were the matches I managed to do in Fight Club. But over the next week, I'm going to be playing in Tourney to hopefully find and then beat the bot once again. Anyway, I've been It's One. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.